you okay? That was a nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals.
It's the final chapter of the season then here at the spectacular Yas Marina Circuit. It's a race where the pole sitter failed to finish in three of the first four events. A front row start here is by no means a guarantee of victory. So we go into battle once more then, as we get underway at the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. We have 16 corners here at Yas Marina Circuit, 7 to the right and 9 to the left. It's a total lap distance of 3.28 miles, two long straights and overtaking opportunities throughout the lap. And we expect average speeds of around 123 miles per hour. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And Lando Norris lines up alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Russell, Gasly, Charles Leclerc, and Tsunoda. Stroll, Vettel, Ocon, they've taken a grid penalty, and Kevin Magnussen. Joe, Bottas, Fernando Alonso, and Sainz. Hamilton, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Latifi, Alex Albon, they've taken a grid penalty, and Daniel Ricciardo. Perez, and more. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat is Anthony Davidson. Ant, our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching out for as they head into turn one?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into turn one as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
Let's aim for a strong finish to the season. Decent parking, let's try. Still looking good. but take care of the car on the way in.
It's been a roller coaster season, but they can go into the winter with their heads held high after an emphatic victory here today. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners. Your driver of the day.
Well, you can't fault anything that Sergio Perez did out on the track today. He drove flawlessly, making him an easy pick.
So then, Ferrari have now moved out of sight and out of reach. It's another triumph for the Italian team as they claim the World Constructors' Championship. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix. The marketing department needs some assistance to reach a resolution here. Thanks for dealing with that. The department appreciates it.
You're not currently in a rivalry. Sooner or later, you'll probably be asked by the media who you consider to be your rival. Think carefully who you select, as while you will receive acclaim for beating them, you'll lose acclaim if you fail to do so.
We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for this weekend has failed. Any redevelopments will need to be ordered from the R&D screen. Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend. Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process.